Hello children, in this class let's study about the solid shapes. In the previous class we know about the plane shapes or the flat shapes. Flat shape means very thin, it will be like a piece of a paper. It will be a flat shape like this. It is a piece of paper like this, the flat shape will be. No thickness is there, no thickness. It is very thin. And this one will be looking as a cuboid. This one is looking as a cuboid. Sorry, rectangle. This one is a rectangle. You can see these two are long sides, and this one is a short side. Very thin it is, and this one is considered as a rectangle. And like this one, another shapes are there which are called as a solid shapes. We will call those as solid shapes. Now these solid shapes differ from the plane shapes by having a volume like this. So this one is a volume. If you see here, it is very thick. Here it is a thick one. This is called as a volume, which takes some place here. If I keep it on a hand, I am keeping a duster on a hand. This one is taking some place. So you can see here it is having some place. Thickness is there. That thick objects we call those as a solid shapes. Solid shapes, right? Now in this first one you will learn is cube. First one is a cube. How this cube will come means, we know that first plane is square. First plane figure is a square. If I hold a square and if I stretch that square over some height, we will get a cube. Means one more square we need to draw and joining the sharp ends we will get a cube. But what I have done, one square I took a square, I have stretched it and I have joined the corners. So this one is called as a cube. Cube is originated or came from a square, single square. We have done a cube. So one side of a square is a cube. One side, this is one side, the front side. The one side of a cube will look like a square. It will look like a square. One side will look like a square. This is the first one, solid shape. And the next one is cuboid. Cuboid comes from a rectangle. So we need to draw a rectangle. The rectangle has two long sides and two short sides. Cuboid comes from a rectangle. Now I will stretch that rectangle by drawing one more. So by joining one more rectangle we will get a cuboid. And one face of a cuboid we will get a rectangle. One face we get rectangle. From a square we will get a cube. From rectangle we will get a cuboid. These are the solid shapes. Why do we call this as a solid shape? Because it has some thickness. Even you can take the example of your textbook. Even you can take the example of a textbook. This one will be example of a cube. This one will be an example of a cube. You can hold like this also or like this also. If you see, we have two long sides and two short sides. The first face is a rectangle and even you have a thickness here. This one is a thickness. So this one is a cuboid. This is an example of a cuboid. We have a rectangle and also we have a thickness. This one will be the example of a cuboid. Now coming to the next one. The next solid shape is a cylinder. How does the cylinder comes? The cylinder will be formed from two circles. I will draw a circle, or by seeing we can say it is an oval shape. One oval shape and another one. I will join these two sides. So this is a cylinder. The example for the cylinder, you can give a water bottle. Water bottle will be an example for your cylinder. Here you will be having two circles and this one two lines joining the circles forms a cylinder. Or even this stick is also an example for a cylinder. You can observe here you have a circle and here also you have a circle and we have joined this. So this one will be an example of a cylinder, or even you can give the example of water bottle. And also this chalk piece is an example of a cylinder. Here one circle, here also one circle. So many examples you can give for a cylinder. And next shape is cone. The cone comes from one side, it will be having a circle. One side it will be having circle and other side it will be having the sharp end. One side circle and one side the sharp end. And you can give a birthday cap. Birthday cap will wear now on any friend's or yours birthday. That is an example of a cone. Or else you can give an ice cream cup. Ice cream cup also is an example of a cone. This cone can be written upside down also. That is also correct. Like this. One side you can draw a circle and other side the sharp end. That is also an example for a cone. Either you can draw like this or like this. Both are correct. And the last solid shape is the sphere. Sphere is one more example. See the sphere. Sphere, while drawing, it looks like similar to the circle, but you have to give some shade in one side. This one is the sphere. It is different from circle. Circle means simply a piece of paper in round shape, but sphere means like your ball. Sphere means like your ball. It has some volume. If you hold it on your hand, it takes some space. That is a sphere. These are the five types of the solid shapes. Now let us give some examples for these solid shapes by writing all the shapes together. So first one is a cube. Second one is cuboid. Third one is cone or cylinder. And fifth one is a sphere. Now coming to the cube, where you can see the examples of the cube, you can tell cube can be ice cubes. Observe in your refrigerator or a fridge, you will get the ice cubes which will be in the shape of a cube, right? Or else the box, gift box, some gift box will be in the shape of a cube. Even you can give many examples, right? Two more examples from your side. And coming to the cuboid, cuboid you can give the book or geometry box geometry box also looks like a cuboid, right? And cone. Example of a cone can be ice cream or birthday cap. Or while going on the road, the construction is happening, they will be keeping some obstacles which are of cone shape and cylinder. You can give an example of a bottle, right? Other than bottle, chalk piece or a stick. And spear, you can give the ball or fruits. And vegetables, so many fruits and vegetables are of spear shape. Right, now coming to your exercise. In your exercise 4, I'll leave it for you. So if you observe here in exercise 4, there are many things you need to observe and match for the exact solid shape. See, first one is a book. Book is an example for which shape? It is similar to a cuboid. So what you have to do, take the book and match it for the cuboid, right? And next one is a can or a tin, coke tin, right? Pepsi can or a coke tin. That one will be similar to which one? That is similar to a cylinder, right? Next one is a ball. As everyone know, ball is an example for a spear. Like this, you need to finish off this exercise. Alright? Next also you have tracing the objects. Keep an object and trace it over a page. What shape you will get, you need to say that. Alright? As I told, the cube, you will one side of the cube, you will get a square. Right? One side of the cube, you will get square. You need to trace it out and check whether you get square or not. And for cuboid, you will get a rectangle, and for a cone, you will get a circle, even for a cylinder also, you will get a circle, and you cannot trace a sphere. If you are trying to trace a sphere, you get a very small circle, or else you will get a dot. Okay, you can't trace a sphere. These four, you can trace it and check whether these shapes only you will get or not. And one more activity in this class I will give is the solid shapes. Exercise 5, match the following. I know you can do that. And next we have a roll and slide. Take the same objects and check whether you can roll or slide. Roll means if there is a piece of book or a slant, keep it like this. Chalk piece is an example for a cylinder. So you need to check. Keep it here, whether it can roll or not, you need to check. It is rolling, right? So put a tick mark or write cylinder can roll. Or example for a cuboid, you can take a chalk piece box and you need to keep like this in a slant position and check whether it can slide or not. See, it is sliding. This is an example for a slide. This is an example for a slide. So take some objects and check whether the things can slide or roll. That is an activity for today's class. Okay, children, I hope you will finish it off. See you in the next class. Have a nice day. Thank you.